Hello friends, we have planned to discuss today about introduction of choice-based credit system CBCS at the undergraduate level. All of you know that this is an initiative of the University Grants Commission to bring uniformity in the syllabi at the undergraduate level across universities and colleges in our country. Many colleges and universities have introduced CBCS system, choice-based credit system, from July 2015 session. Particularly the autonomous colleges in Odisha have been asked by the government, higher education department, to start CBCS from July 2015, and subsequently from July 2016 the other colleges, affiliated colleges, have been asked to introduce CBCS system. But the Odisha State Higher Education Council in the year 2018 has decided that for all the universities, particularly state-funded universities in the state of Odisha, they will design and develop a model syllabus. And that is the reason why it took one full year for different board of studies of different universities in Odisha to come out with a model syllabus for introducing choice-based credit system at the undergraduate level from July 2019 academic session. Odisha State Open University, which is a new university, has decided to start choice-based credit system from this academic session as per the model syllabus. I am happy to inform you that the UGC has given us approval to start 10 different programs at the undergraduate level, which are all honors programs. So we have been allowed to start BA honors in political science, in history, in Odia, in sociology, economics, English, Hindi, then Bachelor in Business Administration and Bachelor in Journalism and Mass Communication. We could have started it last year, but we are waiting for this model syllabus to be followed by all the universities in Odisha. Hence we thought that we will start it from July 2019. And I am also happy to inform you that more than 1600 students have opted to study these 10 undergraduate programs which we are offering from the current session. You all know that the teaching learning methodology adopted in open universities is different from the teaching learning methodologies adopted in the regular universities. In the regular universities, they have the syllabus, they prescribe textbooks and reference books, and then the teaching learning process starts in the colleges by the regular teachers appointed in every college. But the different methodology that is being adopted in open university is, we provide self-instructional material or SLM to the learners and to the counselors for a brief course of study under a program. And these blocks under each course, under each program, are being offered to the student at the beginning of the session so that they come prepared to attend the counseling session and participate in the discussions. So it's a big challenge for us to prepare self-instructional material under choice-based credit system in a short span of 2 to 3 months. But I am happy to inform you that we have prepared the material. The material has been uploaded on the university website under our e-repository, which is called e-Gyanagar. And many of these materials are in the printing stage, and in another couple of weeks we will be able to give it to the students. So I request all the counselors and of course to the students to bear with us, to go to the website of Orissa State Open University, which is www.osou.ac.in, and in the home page you will find e-Gyanagar, which is the OER, Open Education Resource Repository, or e-repository of the university, and the e-content of all the courses prescribed as per the model syllabus of Orissa State Higher Education Council are available. So till you get the printed material, I request you to please go through the e-content available on our website. So friends, let us discuss about what is this choice-based credit system? What are its broad objectives? How teaching learning process will be conducted? How many classes or contact sessions are to be conducted? How many assignments are required to be completed by the students in each semester? And who are the counselors who will be teaching the learners? These are the broad aspects which I intend to cover in this session. I have already said that it is a uniform syllabus, it's a model syllabus developed by the University Grants Commission for the entire country with lot of flexibilities, and Odisha has taken the initiative. Particularly the Higher Education Department, Government of Orissa, has taken the syllabus, an initiative to develop a model curriculum for all the state-funded universities in the state of Orissa. So the most important characteristic of this choice-based credit system is that it is learner-centric. The learner or the student has a wide choice of courses to be decided by them from among the generic elective courses, skill-based courses, and even the subject-specific elective courses. So we'll be going to that, and we'll have little discussion on each of these. But let me first focus on the basic features of this CBCS system. Apart from the fact that it is learner-centric, it is not teacher-centric. It encourages for both interdisciplinary and interdisciplinary studies. Students will not only study from within the discipline, co-discipline or related disciplines, they can completely switch over to new disciplines of studies. It encourages the student to earn credits not only from one college or one university, but it encourages them to earn credits even from other colleges and other universities besides their parent institution. CBCS also encourages the student to study few credits, say 20% of the credits, through online mode under the Swayam portal maintained by the Ministry of Human Resources and Development, Government of India, and rest of the 80% credits they can earn through the regular mode of teaching and learning. So it basically aims at a holistic and all-round development of the learners. That is the primary objective of choice-based credit system. Now it believes in a common minimum syllabus, which I have said that for the country, the UGC has developed a model syllabus, and from this for the state-funded universities in Odisha and all the affiliated colleges, the Higher Education Council of Odisha has developed a model syllabus with the approval of the statutory bodies of all these universities in Odisha. So there is a common syllabus, there is a semester system. The entire 3 year of study at the undergraduate level is divided into 6 semesters, and the students are supposed to earn credits in each of these semesters. And I'll tell you in due course what are the number of credits that the students are supposed to earn in these 6 semesters. Then there is a common evaluation system which we call as the regulation of the university for assessment and evaluation. Normally 20% weightage is given to continuous and comprehensive assessment, which we call as internal assessment, and 80% is assigned for tournament examination or university examination. And there is a 10-point scale in which a student will be assessed or evaluated, and the minimum pass percentage, overall pass percentage in any course and any program is 40%. So these are the minimum things. So there is a uniform syllabus, there is a uniform semester pattern, there is a uniform grading pattern, and there is uniform guideline for both teaching learning and assessment and evaluation. Now all these courses which a student is supposed to study in these 6 semesters are broadly divided into core courses. Core courses are basically discipline specific courses. Then there are discipline specific elective courses. There are general elective courses. Then there are ability enhancement elective courses. And there are skill based elective courses. So the student have to study these core courses, subject specific elective courses, ability enhancement compulsory courses, skill-based courses and generic elective courses in these 6 semesters. There are 14 core courses which are compulsory. If a student is studying at the honors level, 14 core courses are required to be studied in 6 semesters. And a student has to minimum study for 148 credits in the entire period of 3 years or 6 semesters. So within these 6 semesters, student is required to study 14 core courses. There are 2 core courses in first semester, 2 core courses in second semester. There are 3 core courses in third semester, 3 core courses in the fourth semester, 2 core courses in the fifth semester, and 2 core courses in the 6th semester. So altogether the number of core courses comes to 14, and these are basic discipline related courses which UGC has said that any university can make around 20 to 30% changes. But since we have adopted the model syllabus developed by the Odisha Higher Education Council, we in Odisha State Open University have followed all these core courses prescribed by them in toto. We have not made any changes. In the first 2 semesters, the students are also supposed to study generic elective course 1 and generic elective course 2. Similarly, in the third and fourth semester, they are required to study generic elective course 3 and generic elective course 4. So these four generic elective courses, which are required to be completed by a student in first four semesters, can be from one discipline or it can be from two disciplines. The student has the option to decide about whether it will be all four generic elective courses will come from one discipline or they will come from four disciplines. I feel happy to inform you that in Odisha State Open University, we are giving 10 options to the students to study different generic elective courses. And they will decide which course is suitable for them and they feel comfortable. Whether it is a core course or a generic elective course, normally you will find that each course is worth 6 credits. As per the general guidelines of open and distance learning, normally each block is covered in one counseling session, but then it has to be 1 credit worth. So what we have decided is that for 6 credits of core course and 6 credit of generic elective course, there will be 6 counseling sessions of 2 hours each. That means each session will be of 2 hours duration, and for a 6 credit course there will be 6 counseling sessions. For ability enhancement compulsory course 1, we have designed or we have adopted environmental studies, which is a 4 credit course. So minimum 4 contact classes of 2 hours each is prescribed for that. So in the first semester, a BA political science, history, sociology, economics, Odia, English, Hindi, bachelor in business administration and journalism and mass communication, the student will study 2 core courses for which there will be 6 plus 6 contact classes and 1 generic elective course and 1 ability enhancement course. So 6 credit plus 6 credit of core courses, 12 credits, 6 credit of generic elective is 18 credits, and 4 credit of ability enhancement course, that is environmental studies, 4 credit. So altogether it comes to 22 credit. So a student is supposed to study 22 credit, for which you people are the counselors. So I request you to take the counseling session seriously, because these are all plus 2 pass students. Many of them are senior, of course, because they are in open distance learning, and we don't have any age bar for admission to the programs, but majority of them, bulk of them, are plus 2 pass and they have preferred to study through the open and distance learning mode. I request you also to go through the study materials which we have designed and developed for the first time. I'll be happy if you give your feedback to me for further improvement in the content of the course material that we have designed and developed. Many of these materials have been borrowed from Indira Gandhi National Open University and other state open universities under special memorandum of understanding that we have signed with them. But I'll be waiting for your comments. Another aspect that you have to keep in mind is assignments, or what in regular universities and colleges you call as internal examination or internal evaluation. Now here in Odisha Open University, we give 25% weightage to the assignments. And these assignments are to be uploaded on the university website and the students are required to go through the study material to write the assignments. But before that, their counseling classes should be over so that they know what the subject matter is, and they will write the assignments at home and submit it to the coordinator of the study center. We have said that if it is a 4-credit course, there will be one single assignment. If it is a 6-credit course, the students are required to give 2 assignments. That means the first assignment will cover the first 2 blocks, and the second assignment in a 6-credit core course or generic elective course will cover the next 2 blocks. The third Sunday in the month of October is the date that has been fixed for submission of assignment 1 for a 6-credit course and single assignment for a 4-credit course. And the first Sunday in the month of November is the date fixed by the university for submission of assignment, second assignment for a 6-credit course. As soon as the coordinator of the study center will receive these assignments, they will give it to you for evaluation, because you are the counselor and your role also is to evaluate the assignments. But let me also tell you that evaluation of assignment is a very challenging job. Please go through the assignment and give marginal comments and global comments in the comment sheet to the students, because after your evaluation and marks are forwarded by the coordinator to the university headquarters, the evaluated assignment will be collected by the students. They will also see not only the marks that you have awarded to them, they will also see the comments that you have given to them for each question and for their overall performance. And this is a method of communication between an evaluator and the learner, from which the learner will learn how to improve and have a better performance in the term and examination. So I request you to evaluate the assignment seriously and give your valued comments to the students so that they improve in the term and examination. So coming back to this choice-based credit system, I just want to tell you, and to which I just want to repeat again, that in the first 2 semesters, the students are required to study 2 core courses, 1 generic elective course, 1 ability enhancement course. So in the 3rd semester and 4th semester, the students are required to study 3 core courses in each semester and 1 skill-based courses. They are required to study a skill enhancement course in the 3rd semester and 4th semester. That means 2 skill-based elective courses of 4 credit each, total 8 credits, to be studied in the 3rd semester and 4th semester, other than 3 core subjects in 3rd semester and 4th semester. And in the 5th and 6th semester, they will be studying 2 core courses in each semester and 2 discipline-specific elective courses. So it's a huge syllabus for all 6 semesters for the students, covering 14 core courses, 4 generic elective courses, 4 subject specific elective courses, 2 skill based elective courses, and 2 ability enhancement compulsory courses. If a student wants to get honors and earn 148 credits. Please also note that as per UGC regulation for CBCS, 148 credit is minimum, but they can also go up to 160 credits by choosing either a project course of 8 credit worth, if they have got minimum 60% marks up to the 3rd semester, or they can also choose some more elective courses. So 148 is minimum required number of credits to get honors, but one can also go up to 160 credits. So it depends on the university or the college to offer them either 148 or 160 or between 148 to 160. And it also depends on the university to offer them 20% of the courses through the SWAYAM platform in the online mode as per the UGC SWAYAM regulation of 2016. We in Odisha Open University are seriously planning to offer the online advantage to the students so that they can study from any university in the country through the online mode. They can even opt for a course offered by the IITs and other institutions of national repute so that they get exposed to the new methodology of teaching and learning and the best teachers available in the country in disciplines. So, dear friends, this video has been prepared with an objective not only to guide you, to orient you, to inform you about the newly introduced model syllabus in the pattern of choice-based credit system in the state of Orissa, but it also will definitely help the coordinator and other functionaries of the study center to know about the university strategy for implementing the choice-based credit system in Orissa. I request all of you to give utmost attention to the requirements of the students, because for the first time the students will be exposed to the undergraduate program under choice-based credit system through Orissa State Open University, and I sincerely hope that the beginning should be good. And I feel that if beginning is good, 50% of the battle is won. And all my vision and mission about this open university, particularly in terms of quality in the teaching learning process, depends on how the counselors are transacting the teaching learning business in a classroom environment, in a contact class, and how the coordinators and functionaries of the study centers are offering quality support services to the students. I wish you all the very best. Thank you very much.